Empire is a very important category for me in hermeneutics. In my book, Faith in the Face of Empire, The Bible Through Palestinian Eyes, I tried to show actually how we can read the whole Bible as the people of Palestine wrestling with this question of empire. Because Palestine has been, unfortunately, for so long occupied. We had the Assyrians, the Babylonians, the Persians, the Greek, the Romans in ancient times. I mean, just imagine Jesus was born under occupation. He lived his entire life under occupation, was crushed on the cross by the occupational power of that time, the Roman power. So how can we understand the Bible if we don't give attention to that context of empire? But unfortunately, that context of empire continued in Palestine through the Byzantines, the Arabs, the Crusaders, the Ottoman, the British, and now the Israeli occupation of Palestine. And so for me, the people of Palestine who have been occupied for so long have been all the time wrestling with this question, where are you, God? Why don't you come to rescue us from the empire, from occupation? How can we be free? How can we have salvation? How can we be saved from the empire? And so the whole question about salvation is very much connected actually to liberation and thus to empire. But also questions like, who is my neighbor? Because when Palestine was under two different magnetic fields of empires, the neighbor became the enemy. And so the relationship between the people of Palestine to each other is a very important aspect. And so all of this actually at the end of the day is connected to empire. What I'm trying to do right now is to look at Christian-Muslim encounter in the context of empire. And especially if we look at the Middle East in the last 150 years, we see actually that most of the encounters Christian Muslims encounter in our region were triggered by empire. For example, if we think about the Druze Maronite conflict in the middle of 19th century, it wasn't just a conflict between two Lebanese groups, but it was within the larger context of French, British influence and control of Lebanon. Or if we think about the religious landscape is very much influenced by empire. So if you look at where Sunni Islam is found today, it's very much connected to the Arab and Ottoman Empire. Shiite Islam is very much connected to places that came under Persian rule. If you look at the Greek Orthodox Church, where it is found today, it has to do with the Byzantine Empire, the Catholics and the Protestant having to do with European penetration and imperial penetration of the Middle East in the 19th century or before. So you can see actually that the whole religious landscape was influenced by empire, but also the interaction in the last 150 years in the Middle East had more to do with geopolitics than with theology. And this is exactly my my thesis. Now, the other thing is, once empire become weak, then the different groups and religious communities in the region, they start negotiating the future state or their homeland or their relationship. And sometimes that's contested. There is a pull and push factor. and they try to agree what kind of state, what kind of reality they would like to agree together on in a post-colonial era. And again, we have many examples of that, like in Lebanon or in Palestine or in Syria, etc.